Well, happy 4th of July. I've been uploading a video. Well, actually, I uploaded it last night. I took a bunch of fireworks off of YouTube, remixed them, remastered them, you know, added the chroma key and took out all the black and added extra fireworks, remixed fireworks shows together. And I loaded this up last night around, say, about 7:45. Still processing. Last week, the system told me I was not permitted to upload videos. And now I'm just sitting there shocked, stunned, that I put a fireworks video for the 4th of July up. And still to this day, it's not up. So then I decided, you know, I was re-uploaded about 40 minutes ago. And it was last night, it said, when I was uploading, it said like 300 something minutes. Right now it's got 96 minutes left. But when I go back and look, it's showing the one I'm uploading today as the one I uploaded last night. I get tired of this. This happens to me too much. I've been complaining about the fact they claimed I clicked on my own videos, told them to show me the proof. All of a sudden, I lost access. They sent me all this partner crap, but I can't get paid. That's why we stopped doing videos. That's why the quality of the videos took a crapper. That's why you don't see me in the studio mixing music and doing stuff like that. That's why you don't see the green screen being used. Why? Why should we sit down and write a skit for them to say I took it from somebody else? It's ridiculous. I mean, you get burned out. That's exactly probably what happened. So, hopefully you get to see these fireworks. If not, that's just too bad. He knows my eyes are going that way because my screen is right there. Look straight ahead at it right there. Camera's right here. Stick this little camera over here. What do we gotta clean up? Stick this camera right here. Now I can't see my face. It is what it is. I know. It is what it is. So, that's why it's that way, and that's the way it'll be. You get tired. You get ticked. You get angry. You get frustrated. You get discouraged. And that's how it is. They want to discourage you from making videos. They want to discourage you from making people think. They want to discourage you from telling the truth. You know, like I said, and I proved millions of times before in the past, I can get on here and say any wild, crazy, stupid, dumb stereotype. I can act like the stereotype, and the video goes directly on the internet. I proved it several times in the past. You know, it's just frustrating. It is what it is. I do want to do a live show maybe in a few weeks. People want me to do some work for them, so I want to check into that first. And then see if I get a group of people together and have a discussion. A group of people that will be honest enough to tell you how they feel, regardless of what race, color, or your sexual orientation. They just don't give a crap, and that's their attitudes. So, it's kind of working pretty fair, so I'm just going to let it go and call it a day and shut it down. Oh, yeah. If you think there's a topic you'd like me to talk about in this live show, write it on the bottom of the video. You know, one of my subscribers said he couldn't watch a video or a live show that day. I understand that, because I wasn't ready to do one that day either. So, thank you, and I have been reading. I do read the comments on the videos. Oh, one more thing I noticed. Somebody sent me, a lady, over 50 and fabulous, sent me a video from her. I looked at the video. It was a cool, cute, funny video. I laughed at it. I commented on the video. Next thing you know, I was subscribed to the page, and this lady's videos was plastered all over the front of my thing. I mean, I watched one video, and that's it. And now I'm subscribed and everything. It's not what I wanted to do. So I went back and unsubscribed. Somebody ended up sending me another video, and I watched another couple of videos. And I comment. So next thing you know, I go to my Google feed, and it's there that I commented on somebody's video. Now, personally, I didn't comment on the video as who I am. I commented on the video as the real AIX. I didn't need that to be under my name. You see what I'm saying? I mean, sometimes I do research on YouTube and I look at some weird, crazy stuff, or, you know, listen to a bunch of religious stuff, or even listen to the conspiracy theory stuff. If I comment on a video, I don't want it plastered on Google. I don't want to do a video and it goes automatically to Facebook. I can give two shits about Facebook. Fuck Facebook. Snitchbook. Ratbook. You know, take a picture, somebody else puts your name on it. Facial recognition book. I do Facebook 2 to 3 times a year. I'm just gonna say 4. 4 times, you make it annually. And that's it. Because there's no purpose for Facebook. There's no purpose for Google telling people I commented on some 50-year-old lady's video. There's no purpose for that. What's the purpose? A comment, somebody telling somebody, I've seen worse on YouTube. Do what you do. There's no purpose for that. What is the purpose of... All of a sudden, the other day, I looked, and I had no followers on Google. Fine. Now I got something like 900 followers on Google. Not 900 followers, but 900-something and 40-something. It was zero, and now there's numbers there. I mean, the fact that I commented on a video, I was positive, that's that. It's sad that everything I said in the past will be taken out of context. It's sad that if you remember the past, you can't speak of it. It's sad that you have to think about what you say before you say it, because you're going to offend somebody to the point they're going to threaten to kill you. I've been threatened several times with death on YouTube. Nobody's trying to save me or send squad cars to my home. No. But now Google wants you to put your name on everything you said. Now, people have to remember, when I started YouTube, they only gave me 10-minute videos. And I'd comment in the videos we cut. My videos would get 8 minutes and 50 seconds, or 9 minutes and 40 seconds. Time after time after time, my videos were cut. And a lot of my videos, when you go through the history of the archive of my videos, they said re on them. It's a reply to somebody else's video. I've been here long enough for my replies to be there and the other people's videos no longer exist. So when you watch the video, you watch it from one side and one perspective, and it sounds slated. You don't hear the whole debate. And first of all, in those old videos that used to get cut off, if you ever listen to any of my videos, my point is made at the end of the video, not in the beginning. Sometimes there's a message in the middle. But that is what it is. I think I got like 3 seconds left. I don't know. I'm just gonna go until it just stops. Now it's like it speeded up. Serious. Literally, the timer got to 10 minutes and speeded up. But a couple months ago, I did a video on my Surface when I first got the Surface, and it never uploaded. Never. It's still on the Surface. And I'm just getting tired of it. When they force you to edit your videos, and you know, it's like, I'll do the video, I can go over it, I can, okay, listen to it, okay, if I'm not, okay, I can put it up. But then they don't put my videos up. I should turn the camera around and show you where there's two videos loading since last night. You can only discourage the weak-minded, and that's one thing I'm not. So you've been tubed.